10% of all Parkinson's we see are below the age of 40. And 1 in 50 over the age of 80 will get Parkinson's. So it's going to, numbers are going to rise exponentially as we get older.
So you've come across a close link between Parkinson's and the gut. Can you explain a wee bit about that?
Yeah, it's probably one of the most exciting discoveries in the last 5 or 6 years, is the importance of gut in two ways. One, it might have a role to play in the development of Parkinson's, and secondly, it has a key role in how we treat Parkinson's. So if we go to the first aspect, the development of Parkinson's, there is now growing evidence that the gut, which is connected by a nerve called the vagus nerve to the lower part of the brain, can actually transmit a pathogen. So this could be either an infective process or inflammation that first starts in the gut, spreads by the vagus nerve to the lower part of the brain. We now know that this particular part of the brain is one of the first organs to be affected in Parkinson's.
So before, we thought that the vagus nerve could only send signals down,
correct,
but now we're discovering that
around,
actually it can go the other way around.
Exactly so.
The sort of research that you found, have you altered the way personally that you eat and think about what you're putting in the gut?
Yeah, I think so. I think, for instance, the nutrition for us generally in the neurodegeneration field, not just Parkinson's, also for dementia, I mean, it seems that exercise has a tremendous beneficial effect, and that's any form of exercise, and also certain types of vegetables, particularly red vegetables, and thirdly, probiotic use. So yes, all of these bound to affect your dietary habits.
Well, thank you so much for your time, and please do keep us up to date, because we're now fascinated. So
absolutely,
as soon as you find out something new, we're at the end of the book.
Pleasure.